Welcome to session 7. Now that we understand how to recognize a mineral remedy, we will go into detail about the characteristics of the metals of the 4th and 5th row. You will be introduced to a number of known and lesser known remedies. The knowledge of these lesser known remedies has been confirmed in cases that were taken and analyzed following the methods of Anverwerke the Vital Approach. Enjoy this session.
In this session, we are going to talk about row 4 and 5 of the periodic table. In session 6, we already talked about the other rows 1, 2 and 3, where the issues were first incarnate, that's the first row. We didn't talk about those two remedies, which are hydrogen and helium, but we talked in all details about the second row, becoming a separate being and learning how to have a separate existence, which was or is symbolized by the birth process. Then the next stage we talked about is once you know how to have a separate existence, how to establish your identity. And this is well symbolized by the growing up of a child, a baby, and I call it from cradle to university. And we discussed the remedies that reflect all those stages. The natrum in the cradle, the silicea in the middle, who has to confirm all of the time, this is me, and to the sulfur, who knows who he is. And today we are going to talk about row 4 and row 5. So, in the periodic table, which is a symbolized reflection of the stages of human life, we have arrived to the next stage. Once you're incarnated, separated and established an identity, now you want to go out and sustain your own existence. In this row, we have many well-known remedies, like Kali and Calcarea, and Ferrum, Cuprum, Zincum, and of course, arsenic. From Kali, we know a lot of rubrics, but it's known as a very dutiful personality who loves law and order, very fearful also, very anxious, very family oriented, although we know the rubrics, he quarrels with his bread and butter, and a lot of anxieties about health. Calcarea, one of our polycrests, one of our best known remedies, is a shy, timid, mild, yielding person who is horrified by the outside world and who has a lot of anxieties about health and the fear of poverty and is very easily overwhelmed. Ferrum, Cuprum and Zincum are hardworking, disciplined members of society who perform well. And of course, arsenic we know as a very anxious remedy with a lot of anxieties about health and a lot of anxieties about money, and he's very concerned about all money matters, and also he is very meticulous and he wants everything in its proper place. Now, if we put all these issues together, we get a very good picture of the whole fourth row. The whole fourth row has as general features that they are building their existence on safety and security and certainty. And this is obtained by having a steady job, a house, a family, a regular income, an insurance and a pension. So what they try to do, their purpose in life is to sustain themselves and obtain as much stability and safety as they can get. And in their mind, in their idea, the way to get it, the way to obtain it is by having a predictable life. So they don't mind routine. They are not in for adventures. At the contrary, they want safe, predictable daily things so they can plan their life and base their certainty, the security and the stability upon that, because that's their condition to be okay. So this hardworking member of society doesn't want to be special, he wants to be like everybody else. And the health issue on the fourth row is very important, because if there's some disease or some health problem, this confronts the person with, it's unavoidable that it confronts him with uncertainty. He doesn't know where it will lead to, maybe extra costs, maybe a loss of job, maybe uncertainty about the future, and that's why we have so many health issues in the fourth row. Now maybe you think everybody's talking about family and job, how can I know the person needs a remedy from the fourth row? And indeed, I think, and I'm afraid, a lot of our patients get the remedy from the first row only because they talk about work and family. And then we conclude that's their main issue, that's where the problem is, and that's why they need the remedy of this row. But everybody talks about job and family because everybody has a family, that's for sure, because everybody has parents, and most people have a job. So that's the arenas in life where you can perform, or you have problems, or you have connections, and that's where we spend our daily life. But it doesn't mean that they need a remedy from the mineral kingdom or the fourth row. Because let's say there's a problem in the family, there's a quarrel in the family. If it's a plant, he could perceive it, the problem, he could experience the problem as a loss of connection with the family, or a deception from a family member, whereas an animal kingdom patient could feel it as a threat because he's no longer a member of the group. And it's only the mineral who feels it is the foundation for his existence. His whole existence is built upon this security in sustaining himself. So that is what makes it a four-row remedy. And of course, according to the column, there will be an increase and a more stability towards the 10th column, and a decrease in foundation and stability from the 11th to the 18th column. If we go now a bit more in detail to the remedies, it will become all very clear. So the cali we already discussed, it's row 1, it's column 1, row 4, excuse me, and so it is complete dependence. They depend completely for their sustainability on the family, or what they conceive as family. If they don't have a family in reality, then it could be their group, the group where they belong to, and they will treat all those people as family members, and they will quarrel with them because they are so dependent on them that they have to, no matter what happens, to somehow connect with them, stay in the group. Even if they disagree or there are disputes, then they will quarrel, but they won't break the connection, they will stay in the group. Whereas other people might leave the group if there are disputes, or they don't like the people, or they don't feel well in the group, they might look for another group or prefer to stay alone. Not Kali. Kali is so much dependent that he will stay but quarrel. And another Kali symptom is the impulsiveness. They are easily started and they have a lot of anxieties. And the main anxiety, of course, is to be alone. They like company, they're very anxious when alone, and a lot of anxieties about health. Now the calcarea, we already said, it's a remedy with many, many, many symptoms. We know this yielding, mild personality, and one of the main symptoms of the characteristic symptoms is horrible stories affecting profoundly. And what does it mean? What is horrible stories? Now, in the mind of a calcarea, a horrible story is about everything that you can daily see on your television screen. So the news for a calcarea is one horrible story, because all he sees, all he perceives is social unrest, it's war, it's accidents, and about everything that he's afraid of. So the calcarea longs for, needs, because he's so dependent, needs a safe environment. That's why we say it's like an oyster in his shell. It's a weak organism, and it needs a firm shell to protect it. So the calcarea personality, the person, as long as he can stay inside within this protective shell, he's more or less okay. That's the only foundation and stability he has under his feet. But the moment he has to go into unknown territory, or he has to do something new, that's like a horrible story. It's like he opens the door of his safe house, he looks into the world and he says, oh my God, it's horrible, and he closes the door again. That's the calcarea. So by the least opposition, by the least stress, by the least challenge, he will withdraw and he will feel overwhelmed. It's too much. He can't cope, he can't do it. Scandium, for instance, that's the next stage, the third color, is not well known. But because we know the characteristics of the whole row, and of course we have the work of Jan Scholten, who explained all the characteristics of the columns, we can combine them and understand the remedies that are lesser known. And so in this way we can fill the gaps. Scandium is in row 3, and we have column 3, we have column 3, column 4 and column 5, and we call them the columns of doubt. Column 3 is doubt what, column 4 is doubt if, and column 5 is doubt how. So if you combine the characteristics of the row with the doubt what do you get? It's the person who asks himself, I want to sustain myself, I feel the need to do it, but what will I do? He doesn't know what to choose, so he has a lot of difficulty to actually know what he wants, or if he has an idea what he wants, he doesn't know what to choose. Will I choose this direction, or is this a better choice, or will this give me more guarantee to obtain what I need? And that's in the same way that Illumina is doubting what is my identity, the Scandium is doubting what to do. He wants to go out in the world, he wants to assert himself, but what to do? The next remedy is Titanium. Titanium is column 4, doubt if. So he has a more or less idea what he wants to do. But he's not sure if he has enough capacity, because it's a mineral, it's all about capacity. Can I? Do I have enough capacity in order to do what I need to do in order to be okay? So do I have enough capacity? Will it happen? The job that I want or need to feel safe, the relationship that I want or need to feel safe, will I have a family? Will I be able to obtain a house? All those things are the issues of Titanium. And they cannot live with this uncertainty. They need the certainty to know things that they need in order to be okay will actually happen. And you know, the fourth column is the column of the start. That's where the problem feels he has to start, but he has problems to start. It's a difficult start. He doesn't know how to start. So whenever you have a patient where you feel this is the core issue, how to start, you're in the fourth column. Then we have column 5, and that's the doubt how. And in the fourth row, this is the reflected by the remedy Vanadium. Vanadium knows what he wants to do. He's not doubting that it will happen, but he asks himself, how will I do it? How will I manage? How will I go about? What does need to happen in order to obtain the thing I need? And because he's still hesitating and he's not sure about how, he will try something and then withdraw. He tries something else and changes his mind. So he will alternate between doing this and not doing it, and trying something else and stopping again. So that's the alternation, the going back and forth of the fifth row, with all the issues, fifth column, with all the issues of the fourth row. Next remedy is chromium. Chromium is not very well known as a remedy on its own, but it's quite well known as a combination remedy, the Kali-B chromium. And the chromium element in the cow lipi, that is a well-known remedy, and is called by Vitulkas, you remember, the apple polisher. The chromium element is the part that makes it shiny. That's the part that performs well, that is very meticulous about all details. So if you have chromium on itself, it is in the column that it needs to challenge what he wants to do. He is ready to take a challenge. He wants to perform well, he goes out there even when it's difficult. So he faces the difficulties and he wants to perform and shine. Next is manganum, that's the seventh column, and the seventh column is learning it, having more foundation, having more firm ground under their feet, but still they have to learn more, still they have to train, still they have to expand their capacity before they have this full certainty. They want to do it more and more, test it, be sure. And that's what manganum is always trying to do. And because it's the seventh row, they're not ready to do it on their own. So they prefer to be in a team and they prefer to cooperate. They feel safer when there's a team with co-workers and they can assist each other, they can help each other, and somebody else can add to the project or whatever. So that's for them the ideal situation. Column 8, we have ferrum. Ferrum, which is iron, one of our well-known remedies. And I always tell my students, remember just one word, and the word is firm, because ferrum stands for firm. It is a firm personality. It's the one that we know is intolerant for contradiction, and they have the disposition to contradict. So what does it mean? It means that he has an attitude that I know how things should be. And I know how society should be arranged, I know what is best for everybody. If everybody does this, that and the other, then we have law and order, then we have security for everybody, and everybody has a normal and safe life. And he knows how everything should be. Politicians should do it like this, law should be like this, police should control, and that the laws are really followed. And if people don't do that, they should punish them and put them in jail. And then we have social rest. That's how things should be. And he doesn't accept any objection. And because he's only at column 8, so he's not really sure of himself. And only the person who is not sure has to defend very vigorously. Because if you're sure, you can manage somebody who is not in agreement with you. Okay, you have your idea and somebody else has another idea, there's no problem. But if you feel that your idea is not really very well established or not very safe yet, then you have to be rigid. You cannot afford yourself to be flexible yet. So that's why this ferrum personality is so rigid. And he has a soldier-like discipline. Because we know he has delusions about soldiers and delusions about criminals. It's all based on proving symptoms. And isn't it funny that those issues came up in the provings? And so they are the example for the other. Hardworking, well-performing, responsible. That's the metal qualities. And with a soldier-like discipline. And everybody should be like that. And then there's no problem. We all know that. So cobalt is the next stage, which is row 9, and cobalt is even more because it's coming closer to the success, the summit, the top, that's the 10th stage. It's almost there, almost attained, almost his purpose. But the more you are limited by yourself, or you limit yourself to a certain behavior, the more you feel guilty when you're not making it. When you feel like everybody should do, everybody should act, everybody should think in a particular way, and you don't do it yourself, you don't manage to do it always, or you make a little mistake, you can't accept. It's absolutely unacceptable by yourself, because if you want this for everybody, it's the same for you. So your conditions are very, very limited. And every deviation should be punished, not only from the others, but also from yourself. And we see this reflected in the cobalt delusion, and it's even a single symptom. Delusion, he's a criminal, meaning I did something wrong, I'm a criminal, and everybody knows. So he even feels like every little mistake I will make, everybody will know. Everybody will see. So they cannot afford. They cannot afford the least mistake or fault, and that's why they have a lot of guilt feelings, of course. And they're very hardworking. They don't allow themselves any mistake or any rest, and they will rehearse and rehearse over and over again. Column 10 is symbolized by Nicolum. And Nicolum is in the success position. He's the summit. He is justified. He knows how things should be, and he actualizes them. And he's completely independent. We see from column 1 to column towards column 10 that the dependence, which is maximum at column 1, decreases because he's less and less dependent on the others to feel this certainty that he really needs. When we evolve a little bit further, we go to column 11, we see there cuprum. Cuprum, a well-known remedy for cramps. So again, this is easy to remember. Cuprum is cramps. And with the issues of the whole row, we feel that, or we understand that cuprum is the one that's trying to hold on. And he holds on in a crampy way. He tries to maintain and to preserve everything he has, although it's already a little bit slipping away. And where we saw the delusions about criminals and police, we see now the pursuit or the delusion he's pursued by police. And also the delusion that he's a general. You remember it was soldiers in Ferrum. Now we are already a little bit higher in rank. Column 12 is zincum, and zincum, a well-known remedy for instance, fidgety feet, is a very restless remedy, and the feeling is he is attacked from all sides. His sustainability, his certainty is attacked from all sides, and he's restlessly trying to sustain himself, and he feels in the background it is slipping away. He can't stop it from slipping away, and that's why this restless activity all of the time. And in Gallium is the 13th stage is already one of withdrawal, shrinking and reducing. The 14th column is Germanium, and we have a good extensive proving of Germanium by which we can understand the remedy very well. In Germanium we see that his sustenance is so much in danger that he becomes a really hypochondriac. He thinks by the smallest ailment or the smallest pain that things are going to be fatal, and he becomes desperate. So he's very easily in a panicky state from the least thing. And we get those patients. I'm sure you recognize those patients, and you wonder why all the fuss. It's just a little thing. Why so much panic? Nothing's really the matter. But they are convinced they are going to have a heart attack or something like that. And in his mind, he has this same uncertain feeling, and it presents itself very much like a podium picture. And I'm sure a lot of those patients went from a homeopath with a lycopodium, and the homeopath felt very secure that he had a real, typical, clear lycopodium picture. Because of the cowardice. The question is, do I have the capacity to fulfill whatever I have to fulfill in my job or in my family, or do I have the courage to face whatever disease I have, or the treatment that is going to present it, or I have this special project in my job, and do I still have the capacity, because I was always a hard performer, but now, so they are hypochondriac, they are coward, and they are very, very shaky. And they used to feel, or they feel that they used to be capable people. But remember, it is all in the mind. It doesn't have to be like that in reality. It doesn't have to be their real life story. The 15th column is our well-known arsenicum. I don't have to tell you too much about arsenicum because it's a well-known remedy. We all know the arsenicum personality with this restlessly, suspiciously running around and trying to keep what he has. Because his feeling is, his deeper feeling, unaware, unconscious, is I'm losing it. It is crumbling away from all sides, like he stands on his foundation and the foundation under his feet is crumbling away. A part here, a part there, a part there. So he wants to be everywhere at the same time. He's looking around for, is everything still in its proper place? And he's trying to keep it there because his whole existence is based on this safety. And it's when he's adjusting one side, it's crumbling away on the other side. So that's why he's in a panic. He feels destruction is near. And that's why he's so fearful and he's always feeling so unsafe. Again, this is all delusional. 16th column is selenium, and selenium really lost it. It's over. It's in ruin. It's decay. It's gone. That's what he feels. And the 17th bromium, well, end of the story. Close down, we had it, forget it, leave it and quit. These are the key words for the 17th column. You have to, of course, combine them with the fourth row issues. So, in general, it's very clear, I think now, the fourth row issues are all about leading a normal life, trying to have a life like everybody else, trying to belong to the masses, trying to be a normal citizen, having what everybody has, like family, children, house, a car, steady job, 3 times a year on holidays, and a pension later. So your whole future is already planned and safe. If nothing comes in the way, you know exactly how it's going to evolve. There's no need and there's no courage to stand out of the masses. You don't want to be somebody special. That's the issue of the fifth row.